All right. Well, I think we're ready.
You can find us at BWSSpodcast.com and on Facebook at BWSSpodcast. This is Because We Said So. Let's start the show.
Speakers.
Speakers, yes.
And now, recording from beautiful and sexy Miami with your hosts, Seth and Laz and Research Lucas. It's Because We Said So.
Sure is. It's Because We Said So, folks. And for those of you who are following us from the very beginning, we got Ricky here. And we're just going to jump right to it. We got Ricky in the house, a.k.a. Dr. Talk, a.k.a. Shake and Bake, a.k.a. likes to work with possums, you know?
Possums?
Yeah.
Remember the possum story?
Remember the possum story?
No.
He's like, I'm not working with a... Yeah, they find like a possum.
Oh, yeah, inside the building.
Yeah. Totally. Totally.
I remember.
So we got Seth here, Mike 1. We got Laz back there and Mike 2.
Yo.
Oh, I went to Ricky. There we go. There he is.
Yo.
And we got Ricky and Mike 3. Or no, we got, Lucas and Mike 3.
Hey.
You can tell I got a lot going on today. And then we got Ricky and Mike 4. So there we go. Seth, Laz, Lucas, Ricky, and then all of us. So, which is nice. So we're going to be talking about the U.S. election aftermath. Basically all the shit that's gone down from the world leaders and what they had to say. Of course, the lawsuits and all the counting and all that crap. Star Wars toys, they found a big bunch of bags of them worth about $330,000. Anyone see that one?
No.
So China sets a trap with the Hong Kong hotline. And then a three-year-old girl found after 65 hours under the rubble. And this was in the earthquake in Turkey. So 65 hours they found her. So you can get us at our website, bwsspodcast.com, Facebook, Twitter, bwsspodcast, Instagram, it's just bwsscast. And then that's pretty much it. So I think we're going to go ahead and just jump right in.
It's time for quick news.
There we go. So CNN, three-year-old girl rescued alive after 65 hours trapped under rubble in Turkey earthquake. She's been rescued alive in a collapsed apartment building in Izmir, Turkey, following Friday's strong earthquake, according to Turkish state news agency Anadolu.
Well, this was 2 days ago?
This was a couple days ago, yep. The child identified by authorities as Elif Pernicek was rescued on Monday morning, more than 65 hours after a devastating quake. Emergency workers who had worked tirelessly to rescue her applauded as Elif, wrapped in a foil blanket and covered in dust, was carried through the wreckage and into an ambulance. I thought she might be in the space between her and her bed dresser, the firefighter reporter said. I went in that direction, and that's exactly where I found her lying on her back. I picked her up. I cleaned her face and got rid of the dust. She held my finger and wouldn't let go until we got to the ambulance. At least 91 people died and 994 were injured. She didn't have any broken bones, no muscle crush injuries. So, I mean...
Just hungry.
Dude, hungry, probably thirsty, so...
That's great. You know.
Just happy to see somebody.
Yeah.
Yeah, man. That's some... I mean, that's some...
For a three-year-old, bro.
For a three-year-old. Can you imagine? You're just like... You know, you... I mean, the poor kid, man.
And we're all around three-year-olds. We know how that is.
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I'm going to have one next year. All right, go ahead, Laz. French Bulldog?
Oh, French Bulldog. Sorry. All right. So a six-month-old French Bulldog elected mayor of a small Kentucky community. I saw it. I was laughing because you know how all the news has been lately. Just, you know, all the election stuff. So I was like, it's election stuff, something election-y, but not really. So basically,
election-y. He likes it so election-y right now.
So, Lady Stone, a border collier who serves as the town's ambassador, announced Wilbur's win on Tuesday night. The results are in from the most important election that happened this year. Lady Stone wrote on social media before thanking every other candidate for their help preserving this historic town for years to come. So basically, they have an election every 4 years or every couple years.
Sure.
And it's for mayor of the city or the community. And basically, you pay $1 to vote. And whoever wins, all the money goes to the city to keep the city moving.
That's pretty awesome.
It's called Rabbit Hash.
Sure.
And it's located in Boone County.
Rabbit Hash?
Rabbit Hash in Boone County, Kentucky.
Gotcha.
The reason started the first time somebody got elected in 1988. He died, and they made his dog the mayor, and then they just kept going on with it. And it's like a fundraising thing, sure, so it's cool.
That's cool.
I liked that. I thought it was nice.
It's very cute. Yeah. Yes, it's very cute.
It's very cute.
Indeed. All right. BBC algorithm spots COVID cough inaudible to humans. An algorithm developed by the U.S. in the U.S. has correctly identified people with COVID-19 by only the sound of their coughs. In tests, it achieved 98.5% success rate among those people who had received an official positive corona test result. The researchers would need regulatory approval to develop it into an app. They said the crucial difference in the sound of the asymptomatic COVID patient cough cannot be heard by human ears. So in other words, you don't even have symptoms yet, but they still get you. MIT scientist Brian Subriana, who co-authored the paper, said the way you produce sound changes when you have COVID, even if you are an asymptomatic. And this is from MIT.
So what do? You cough on purpose?
That's the thing. Like, so basically what you'll be able to do is getting on an airplane, going to school, going to work, cough here. It's like, bang, get the fuck home. Alarms and shit. So, I mean, it's pretty awesome. Getting regulatory approval usually is pretty expensive and takes a while, but I'm pretty sure they'd be willing to ramp it up, I would think. So that's what's up with that. Cool. All right, cool. Lucas, you're up.
All right, this comes from MSN. The UAE overhauls many Islamic laws to allow for personal freedoms, and they criminalize honor killings.
Okay. Oh, that's right.
Decriminalize?
Yeah. Decriminalize, okay. Yes.
This has been brought about because majority of their... expatriates.
Sure.
I think it was like 80%. Of course, I lost it. But they criminalize honor crimes, which is for women like going and killing. What?
You lost it.
Yeah, I know I lost it.
All right. But so yeah, honor killing is like literally, so you could just be like, they dishonored me, and you can kill them. Whether it was your daughter, your neighbor, your wife, like.
But it had to be a valid dishonor, right? Or just like.
Yeah, sure. Whatever fucking valid dishonor.
Seth called my wife.
Are you sure? You can say it is whatever you want it to say.
You ain't mowing my grass properly. You dishonored me, I'm going to kill you?
Yeah. So, well,
I'm pretty sure it's not going to be any. I'm pretty sure it wasn't anything.
No.
You shouldn't be able to do that anyways, but.
I mean, extramarital affair or, you know, canoodling with the wrong boy. I mean, there's all kinds of things that they could come up with, you know, and lie and this.
You deflowered my daughter.
Sure, for sure, dude, for sure. And what was the other one? They decriminalized.
There was actually a little while ago, but they lifted the ban on alcohol, like alcohol licensing.
That's right.
They had a ban on alcohol.
No alcohol.
No.
And they also added the death penalty for anyone that does anything sexual with, you know, underage or mentally incapable people.
That's cool.
That's cool.
Yeah. Straight death penalty.
Damn.
I don't mind that one.
No, that's cool. For sure. Yep. All right. Go team, man. UAE. You know, baby steps. We'll get there. Are you allowed to kiss in public there? I feel like you're not allowed.
Not even like your wife?
I don't think at all. Anyway, maybe you could look that up.
Research Lucas.
Yeah, behavior like homosexuality and public displays of affection were not broached in the announcement.
Yeah, so you're not allowed to like kiss in public or whatever. Maybe not even hold hands. BBC, Star Wars toys dumped into Stourbridge garbage fetched 250,000 pounds or, you know, $330,000. They and other toys were left to an elderly couple, elderly couple from Stourbridge in the neighbor's will. So in other words, he died, left the house to their neighbors. Couple were unaware of the value of the items, which sold in total 410,000 pounds. They had arranged for skips to throw away many of them, skips being like dumpsters. They were sold by Aston's Auctioneers in Dudley, West Midlands, in its last sale before closing permanently. Auctioneer Chris Aston said he did not expect the items to fetch so much. The best piece was a vinyl Cape Jawa, the guys from the desert in the original Star Wars film. That got 22,000 pounds alone. The unnamed couple had invited Mr. Aston to look at the large number of toys, which belonged to Peter Simpson next door, who left it to him. So guy passed away, left it to his neighbors. They're like, shit, we got a free house. And they realize there's about $330,000 worth of Star Wars toys in there.
Would you have
bought them? That's what's up. You auction them, right? You don't keep them, do you?
What about you?
I would.
I'd probably keep some.
I know you would.
I'd keep all of it.
He'd make a whole fucking room of Star Wars.
Now, the thing is, I'd keep them because it's only going to go up in value.
That's true, too. It's an investment. It's not going to go down.
Nah, no, you open them, open it up and play with them.
What a dickhead.
You would. Yeah, no, I don't know why. Have you seen the studio?
Yeah, that's true. All right. And then let's see. The last one I got, and then we'll be done with the quick news. Hong Kong, BBC, Hong Kong's new hotline to report breaches of the controversial national security law has received more than 1,000 calls within hours of going live. Residents can anonymously send in images, audios, and videos they suspect someone has violated the law. The law, introduced earlier this year, criminalizes secession, subversion, and collusion with foreign forces. It has already led to several arrests of activists and has silenced protesters. Maximum punishment is life in prison. Hong Kong police have received more than 1,000 tips via the hotline Thursday, according to reports, using email, text, and WeChat. By encouraging people to report on friends and neighbors, the Chinese government is replicating in Hong Kong one of its most successful tools for social control and informant culture. This is one of many chilling recent developments in Hong Kong, where the authorities are pulling out new tools to punish and tame the city's pro-democracy involvement. And earlier in the week, 7 pro-democracy people from Hong Kong were arrested. So, you know, China just keeps, you know...
Hold on, what you're trying to say? They're promoting video snitching?
Video snitching, yeah. Email snitching, texting snitching. Wait,
did you text that or I saw that somewhere else?
Snitching. Wait, did I text that?
I don't think so, right?
I don't think I shared that one. Usually stuff that I feel like I might use for quick news, I keep to myself because fuck you guys. So, I don't think I sent that one.
Isn't like borderline peeping?
It is. It's China, though. That's what they do, like, to their citizens. That's not a secret, unfortunately.
No, they watch us, too, but they don't really kind of, they don't interfere. I feel like...
Who, us? No, but this is Hong Kong. They basically took over. Hong Kong was supposed to remain, you know, was able to govern itself or, you know, remain separate and for 50 years, starting in 1997, so 1937, 47, I can do math. And so... Basically, China went in and passed this law saying they can just arrest people. And if you remember the umbrella activists and all that, where there's, you know, tear gassing and they're using umbrellas to protect them. And they've been like demonstrating for, dude, since we were fucking doing this show back in 2016. So they've been doing it for a long, long freaking time and still going. And China's like, you know what? We got to put this shit to bed. So not very happy about that. All right, so that being the case, we're going to move into everyone's second favorite segment.
It's time for...
Wait a minute. Segment. What the fuck?
It's What the Fuck News, everybody. So, Lucas, are you ready with your What the Fuck News for today?
Yes.
By the way, nice background. Thank you. Love how it blends in with your chair back there. It's very cool.
Kind of look like Jesus.
Yeah, right.
What?
Oh, Jesus. Okay, go ahead, Lucas. What the Fuck News? Up. Yeah.
I had to see.
All right. This comes from Yahoo, but I've seen it on some few others.
Sure. Yahoo again?
Yahoo. Yahoo. I can give myself an applause, bro. Just like that.
Yeah, nothing beats a slow clap there.
That's true. All right, go for it. What the fuck news?
Idaho man banned from Yellowstone National Park for attempting to cook chickens in hot spring.
Oh, I saw that.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Oh,
dude. They tried to fry the chicken on the park.
But you can't fry. You mean like boil it maybe?
No, in the hot springs.
Hot boil.
Yeah.
Oh, dude. Gross. Because don't they have like sulfur and crap like that in there also?
I mean, he carrying cooking pots.
Okay. Oh, he brought pots?
Yeah, probably.
No.
Yeah.
Let him tell the story.
But
Idaho man has been issued a 2-year ban from Yellowstone National Park for attempting to roast chickens in a hot spring. After being alerted to hikers is in an off-limits thermal area of the park carrying cooking pots on Friday. A park ranger found 2 whole chickens at a hot spring inside a burlap sack. The identified man from Idaho was sighted along with 2 others in the group for walking in a thermal area.
Walking in a thermal area, so I guess that's off limits. So if it's too hot, okay, fair enough.
They have them blocked off where you could be there safely because have you heard the stories of people falling in?
Oh, yeah, of course. A three-year-old, yeah. It's just like, yeah, not that long ago.
I never heard about
like
that.
Like 2-3 weeks ago.
In Mammoth, and that's pretty much it.
Okay.
So he's banned for 2 years.
But they, I guess you're not allowed
There's another
to,
one from Mammoth Hot Springs from September 10th.
It runs in the family.
Somebody probably video snitched.
Oh, dude. It's like Weaver and Wimp.
Yeah.
Okay, yeah, somebody snitched indeed.
He was charged with violating closure and use limits and was forced to pay $600 per charge plus 2 years of unsupervised probation.
And supervised probation for trying to cook some chickens.
You're not allowed to do it, I think, all the parks. Yeah. In any national park, you're not allowed to do whatever that he was doing.
Okay.
Yeah. He was hungry.
Hey, you fucking cook.
I just want to see if he could do it. Like, wouldn't you, though? I mean, at first, yeah. Like, damn, wonder if I could boil an egg
there. You probably didn't even know.
Well, according to Yellowstone's website, the park's hot springs have injured or killed more people in Yellowstone than any other natural feature.
I'm sure. I mean, that shit gets hot. And people try to get too close. Look how cool it is. You fall in, and that's it. You're done.
Maybe he's trying to do experiments.
Maybe.
See how fast it cooks your chicken.
That could be, you know? I'm sure it cooks it pretty fast.
Or maybe he's done it before. It just never got caught.
That could be too, actually. He might have a hut somewhere and, you know. All right, folks. Well, so let's go with the shout-outs. So, Laz, any shout-outs out there?
Shout-out to Brandy because she's been listening to the show.
Sweet.
Shout-out to... We're good. Shout out to the voters for fucking coming out this year.
Right? Man. Seriously.
Both sides.
Freaking voters.
You know what
man.
I mean? That's crazy. Dude. I think it's the most votes we've ever had.
Yeah, for sure. We'll save it for the show. But yeah, 100% shout out for that. All right. So, Lucas, any shout outs over there?
No.
No? None this week? Okay. No. Ricky, any shout outs out there?
No.
No?
No shout outs.
Okay. All right. Well, I don't really have any shout outs either. So I just want to mention Alex Trebek. So obviously he passed away. Really, really bummed about that. He hosted Jeopardy for 36 years, did over 8,000 shows. It's interesting. It's like 400 game shows had come and gone in the time that he was hosting that show. I remember watching that shit when I was 10, 11 years old. So definitely a bummer. Hope he missed. Question is, who are we going to find to replace him? I'm thinking Ken Jennings. So I feel like he'd be perfect, but we'll see what's up with that. So once again, we put our deleted scenes on YouTube. So those of you watching, listening, if we have them, if they're 5 or 6 minutes, I don't bother. But if we have a decent amount, I usually put them up. I will put them up. And that's it. We're going to take our first break.
Funny.
What's that?
I got something funny.
All right, go for it.
There's something called Black Jeopardy. Ricky was watching it today.
Saturday Night Live. It's funny, dude.
He fell asleep.
No, because they did that. They do that shit on Saturday Night Live. Yeah,
that's the one I was watching.
So he's sitting on the couch, and I hear it. I'm like, yo, this is fucking hilarious.
Elena and I haven't watched it yet, but yeah, they got David Chappelle on there, which is great. And
that's I'm like, who's doing it? And I'm like, yo, this is fucking great.
Yeah.
I love it.
They usually do that when they have a black host come on. Okay. For sure.
Not really. They had a white guest. I forgot her name.
No, they always have one white guest also, but I think I'm pretty sure they did it when Bozeman was on there as well.
Yeah, he was there too. It was fun. That one was funny.
That was really
funny.
I don't
know what to answer.
Go ahead, Lucas.
What?
That's it. Good.
Oh, yeah, and Sean Connery died this week, so...
Yeah, Sean Connery.
Everybody's fucking dying this year, bro. Dude, this is fucking Sean crazy. Connery,
I mean, we are getting older.
Yep. Dude, no, they're already making... There's already people calling out that Will Ferrell and the other guy to remake Jeopardy on SNL.
That'd be cool. I'd be okay with that.
I'll be more than okay with that.
Oh, he's my favorite actor, so I would have no problem with that.
Who's your favorite?
Will Ferrell.
Will Ferrell?
Of course.
Yeah. For comedy?
Butts and holes?
100% for comedy.
So, yeah, for sure. For comedy.
For sure. So he did it. He did a semi, he's done a couple more semi serious roles and he's still good, but you know, in his wheelhouse, you know, unfortunately he does some shitty movies too, but that's okay. We'll forget.
Maybe a shitty movie.
Well, I don't know.
You don't watch all his movies.
Semi pro. It's pretty shitty. Okay, see.
But he's always going to make you laugh, even if it's not a great movie.
For sure.
Yeah,
for sure.
Step Brothers, old school.
Yeah, 100%. 100%. All right, we're going to take our first break. Oh, there goes Laz. Can't wait to get him off. All right, we'll see you guys soon. Boom. Mm-hmm.
changes many things that stay the same. That stay the same.
I mean, it's up to you, man.
Have it available for if I need it.
Oh, shizzle. Oh, speakers. All right. Well, we're back. We're going to get into the election, and we're going to start with how the world sees us. So I got some different, I don't know, clips, I guess, quotes from different world leaders out there. And we're going to jump with this. Is basically, a lot of this was before, like when the after the election, when the counting was still going on. A lot of these are actually all these right here from Al Jazeera. Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei has mocked the racist aftermath of Election Day in the U.S., saying the vote has exposed the reality of its democracy. What a spectacle, he tweeted late on Wednesday. One says it is the most fraudulent election in U.S. history. Who says that? The president who is currently in office. German Foreign Minister Heiko Maas said on Friday the U.S. is more than a one-man show. Those who continue to add fuel to the fire in the current situation are acting irresponsibly. Good losers are more important than great winners. The Kremlin has issued concerns over the process. Foreign Ministry spokesman Maria Zakharova said, obvious shortcomings of the American electoral system are evident, partly due to the archaic nature of the relevant legislation and lack of regulation in a number of fundamental points. So basically, no surprise there. But of course, Alec Navalny, our boy, guy that got freaking poisoned, you know, he loved it. He's like, that's democracy in process. And what's funny is the Brazilian president, who doesn't like Biden at all, because freaking Biden was saying that we should give $1 billion to Brazil to save the rainforest, and there should be repercussions if they don't follow through. So he was like, you know, there's no secret there. You know where I stand. I've been very clear. I have a good relationship with Trump. I hope he gets reelected. And then Zimbabwe said, we have nothing to learn about democracy from former slave owners. So,
oh, wow.
Yeah. So
that's a point there.
Zimbabwe wasn't playing.
That's not
sure.
That bad though.
It's not that bad.
I mean, fuck.
Yeah. Right. I thought I'd say that one to the end. Good. Like, so
that's kind of right.
It is, yeah, you can give it that. I mean, it was like 300-400 years ago, whatever, but sure, 200 years ago.
Do you guys think that any part of the election was corrupt for real? Honestly?
No.
Like voting-wise, and there was like a...
Not by tens of thousands.
No, that I never believed that, though. Even before, like, you know, they always bother Florida for fucking up or this and that.
Sure.
I don't believe that somebody can have that much power to steal votes. Win or lose.
The orchestration that it would take with all the people involved, the only way I could see it happening is if you had like covert CIA operative people who get in as counters and, you know, like some CIA shit, like some top level. That's the only way I could see it happening. It's not like you could just sneak. And I actually have how votes are cast and how ballots are counted and stuff like that when they get mailed in. Like, it's just...
They're just putting it in a machine.
Of thousands. What's that?
They're just putting it in a machine.
Yeah, they do. But what they're saying is,
But when it comes in the mail, it's not somebody physically counting it unless they just don't turn it in.
I don't think they put it in a machine.
I'll jump ahead. I'll jump ahead a little bit. So basically, the way it works is an early ballot package consists of the actual ballot, instructions on how to complete the ballot, and early ballot affidavit envelope. The envelope is used to verify the voter's identity through signature verification. An early ballot cannot be counted unless the voter signs it and the county subsequently confirms the signature matches the voter's registration record. Once the county recorder confirms the signature on the EBA, the early voting application, matches the voter's record, the ballot is transmitted to the election office for tabulation. In other words, when you register to vote, that signature has to be the same. Exactly.
So, I don't even know mine.
So if I was 18 and I had a crappy ass signature, now I'm 20, whatever. My signature changed. It doesn't match. It doesn't count.
How often do you have to register to vote?
I think
one time.
One time.
I haven't been registered per state, I guess.
I don't know.
I have never registered. Yeah.
But that's the thing. Like, you can't just bring in a shit ton of votes like and have them counted because they have to go through this process.
So I'm saying it can't be corrupted. I don't believe so.
No,
unless they just throw them in the garbage.
It happens. Like there have been, you know, voting sales. in Georgia, there was a lot of them going on. People offered $20, you know, for their vote and shit like that. Like, for real. Like,
yeah, but that person, if that person sells their vote, they sell their vote. Who
cares?
And
they went to jail. Yeah, but, yeah, it's but like, thing, like, it's not legal. To sell your vote, yeah, it's a federal crime. That.
But I mean, like, as far as, like, there's not somebody out there buying tens of thousands of votes for
$20. You don't know that.
Who the fuck has that much money? Like, fuck.
Well,
like,
freaking, elected official who wants to win.
Yeah, and what's his name? Bloomberg freaking gave $100 million to Biden just for Florida. So, I mean, plenty of people have it, but there's no way.
But he's not. He's
the amount
not
of people that
it.
Would have to be involved for something like that, there's no way ridiculous. It gets kept a fucking secret. Yeah. For sure. So let's go over the lawsuits that have been filed so far by Donald Trump. USA Today, June 1st, 2016. This is a little lawsuit history. Trump and his businesses have been involved in at least 3,500 legal actions in federal and state courts during the past three decades. They range from skirmishes with casino patrons to million-dollar real estate suits to personal defamation lawsuits. ABC News, with ballots still being counted and no winner yet projected in the presidential election, Trump campaign has been filing lawsuits over ballot counts. The filings are in battleground states where the race is extremely close. Pennsylvania, the Trump campaign and its legal team have pursued several legal actions in the state as election officials count hundreds of thousands of ballots. The campaign filed a lawsuit Wednesday alleging the observers were not allowed to meaningfully watch the vote count in Philadelphia County. Pennsylvania judge on Thursday granted the Trump campaign's request to observe Philadelphia poll workers as they process the remaining mail-in ballots. So the judge's like, yeah, go for it. The city of Philadelphia promptly filed an appeal to the Pennsylvania Supreme Court to overturn the decision, alleging that its poll watchers were not being allowed to properly observe the vote as previously granted. The Trump campaign filed a lawsuit evening intending to stop the vote altogether. Also, they filed a motion to join a pending lawsuit brought by a Pennsylvania GOP seeking to challenge a three-day mail ballot deadline. In other words, 3 days after the ballots, after the election's over, a lot of times you can wait until that Friday as long as it is postmarked. What a lot of people don't think about is, well, they have been thinking about it, but the situation with the military, they have until Friday for it to come in. So, you know, it's not a secret that all these ballots are being freaking counted and shit like that. So the recount in Pennsylvania, if it's by half a point per a percent or less, of course, Biden won by 0.6, so no recount Pennsylvania. That's for sure. I know. Bummer.
Oh, well.
So that's Pennsylvania. And that's the one where you saw most of this crap happening. In Georgia, another pile of crap going on there. Filed a lawsuit with Georgia Republican Party seeking an order to compile, store, and account for all ballots received after the state's deadline. All this, everything received after the deadline, store them on the side just to make sure, because they're definitely doing a recount there. Michigan filed a lawsuit asking vote counting to stop until the courts can enforce rules that permit campaign observers to watch the ballots being opened and counted. They got denied.
Who's paying for these lawsuits?
So, of course he does. He don't give a fuck.
All right, let me ask you a question. You said 3,500 lawsuits, right?
Yep.
What's his track record?
That's a good question. Lucas, can you look up Trump's? I'm sure it's pretty good.
I'm curious.
Can you look up Trump's lawsuit success record, please?
Research Lucas.
That's a lot of lawsuits.
Pretty much. Arizona, another one. So a lawsuit that raises issues with the use of Sharpies on ballots. So after basically a woman used a Sharpie, didn't count her freaking... What's that? Go for it.
In about 500 cases, judges dismissed plaintiffs' claims against Trump. In hundreds more cases ended up with available public records unclear about the resolution. Trump won 451 times and lost 38.
There you go.
And that's from Wikipedia.
Wow.
That's like money with lawyers, bro. I was talking to somebody about it the other day. Like, if you get in trouble, if you don't have a lawyer, just forget about it. You're cooked. Like,
sure. WHYY PBS federal judge dismisses, this is Pennsylvania, Trump's attempt to stop voting counting in Philadelphia. And this is why it's so fucking ridiculous. The Thursday afternoon filing against the city election board sought an injunction to halt vote counting over allegations that observers from the Trump campaign had been unfairly barred from parts of the city's ballot counting area inside Pennsylvania Convention Center. If you remember correctly, they're not allowing our people to go in and watch the counting and shit like that. People are already in there. Like, it's a part of the federal law. Republicans get to choose people to be in there. Democrats, same thing.
Oh, that's how it goes?
That's how it goes.
So there's people on both sides in the voting area.
Already fucking in there.
Oh, come on. That's what I'm trying to say. He wanted more. Where are you gonna fucking steal the votes? Like,
yeah. And oh, you have to steal tens of thousands. So the reason all this shit was happening in Pennsylvania was because of a lot of early voting. And it was like, oh, well, how can they all be for fucking Biden? The reason they can all be for Biden is because Trump spent the whole fucking presidency telling people not to mail in their votes.
Don't mail in.
Yeah. Tell them to show up on the day, yeah.
Yeah, and the Democrats were like, whatever, dickhead. We're going to fucking vote by mail. We've been doing it for fucking years, decades even. So the federal judge seemed to frustrate at time with arguments from the campaign. I'm sorry, then. What's your problem? Said Judge Diamond, a President George Bush, Bush appointee, after Trump lawyers conceded that observers had been admitted into the facility. So, like, the lawsuit, he's in there. The lawyers are like, well, I mean, they were allowed in there. And the judge is like, so what's your fucking problem? Like, seriously. What do you got, Lucas?
From New York, the Philadelphia Inquirer.
Yep.
Commentators calling Republicans to surround Philadelphia. You Philly social media responds, you obviously never met us.
Yeah.
Around of course.
Philadelphia. What yeah. the fuck?
You guys,
I mean,
are
you guys know
crazy.
What we do to fucking Santa Claus and shit. Like,
you
seriously.
Guys are nuts over there, bro.
Yeah.
All right. MIT, what we have in the U.S. now called absentee voting first arose during the Civil War when both Union and Confederate soldiers were given the opportunity to cast ballots from the battlefield units and have them be counted back home. States began passing absentee ballot laws for civilians in the late 1800s. First laws were introduced to accommodate voters who were away from home or seriously ill on election day. In the 1980s, California became the first state to allow eligible voters to request absentee ballots for any reason at all, including their own convenience. By 2018, 27 states had adopted no excuse absentee laws. In other words, no excuse, like, just give me one.
Okay,
according to respondents to the, what's that?
Yeah, it doesn't matter. Like,
yeah, like whatever. Yeah. According to respondents to the 2018 Election Administration and Voting Survey, 26% of voters in no excuse states cast their ballots by mail compared to 9% that still had required an excuse. So in 2018, a lot of freaking cast their ballots by mail. So in 2016, it ended up being like around like 20, I have the graph in front of me, like 23%. Same thing in 2014. So this has been going on for a while. It's not fucking new. The only difference is this year is a lot more of them. And the difference between a mail-in ballot is when you have to request it. Everyone gets one, like mail-in ballot, everyone gets mailed one, and then absentee has to be requested. So
my brother always does absentee ballots because he's always in school. So,
sure.
And now he's in New York. So he's like, he lives in New York, but he's doing his residency. My youngest brother.
I gotcha.
So he can't, he always votes by mail. And it always works out.
Ricky, did you vote?
Yes, I did.
Did you go in? Did you mail?
No, I actually went in.
Did you?
Yeah.
Okay. Did you wait in a long line or?
No. My precinct's in an elementary school, like 5 minutes away from my house. So like 10 minutes at most.
Okay. That's not too bad.
I don't think mine took 10 minutes at all. The whole thing. Like the whole process.
Sure. I hear you. So Lucas, hey, how was your voting experience, by the way?
Quick.
There you go. All right. Georgia Senate runoff. So this is important. In addition to all the presidential bullshit, Trump, by the way, let's just say here, Trump is fucked. There's not a whole lot he can do. Like,
he's not leaving.
He has to leave. He doesn't have to concede. Legally, he doesn't have to concede.
They're going
to
need a wrecking ball.
But he has to fucking leave.
He said he's not leaving.
He's leaving.
He's leaving. He went and played golf again today. So, to drown his sorrows.
I wonder what's going through his head.
He's still a human. He's looking, fucked.
Thinking
bro.
Of ways to win, you know?
Because, you know, usually how after a president is elected, they have to, you know, do the transition.
Sure.
Walk him in. He looks like he's not going to do none of that.
No, he didn't even call.
Take a dump on the freaking Oval Office.
How did he
desk?
Not call? You're supposed to do that call shit, bro.
The call, and then, congratulations. No, not only that, the next couple of weeks, walk him through everything.
He's not going to do any of that shit.
Nah.
No. Not at all. He's going to fart in his hand and try to shake it.
And especially when he got elected, even though a lot of people didn't, they had the whole thing where all the former presidents came and met with him and walked. Was that him, right?
Yeah.
Yep. Yeah. Obama was there. Bush was there. I think Clinton was there, too.
Even Bush congratulated him. So.
Oh,
Bush congratulated Biden.
Yeah.
A lot of Republicans congratulated him.
Fuck yeah, dude.
That'd be the noble thing to do.
I literally do not think that in 4 years that he's running again.
He's coming back.
Or Republicans are not choosing.
I think his son, I think one of his sons has a better chance, or maybe even his daughter, for crying out loud. It's possible. So what, you know, all right, so we'll get into Biden. I mean, I have a lot on them. We'll get into them as well. But here's the thing. In Georgia, there's Senate runoff. Right now, there's 48. Can you double check this, Lucas?
It's still 48-48, right?
Okay, perfect. So it's still 48-48. There are two senator runoffs going on in Georgia, because in Georgia, you have to get at least 50%. And because there was, you know, a few people, both of the Democratic Republicans are both like the 48-49%. So they're going to do a runoff in January, both races. So what happens is, if Democrats win both of them, we will have a 50-50 tie, unless, of course, somehow we get, I think it's Alaska. We're not getting those two. Those are definitely going Republican. So we have to win these two. But if that happens, then the tie goes to the vice president, which would be Kamala Harris. So Georgia, come on, get it together.
Why wait till January to do the runoff?
I don't know. I mean, maybe so they can do a recount just to make sure, or so people can what's the word? Campaign, I guess, to recampaign or some shit like that.
I think everything is officialized in January. I think that's when, even though we have the votes, like the electoral vote, everything is done in January before the thing is over anyways.
That's why I want to make sure they get it done in time so they can, you know, have everybody in place for when the presidency happens.
Oh, you know what I noticed when I went to go vote, like in the ballot, whoever's going against anybody, they don't even put their party. They just put the names. They didn't put Democrat or Republican. So it's like, if you don't know who you're voting for, you're kind of fucked.
No, it tells you.
No, it didn't. Not in my precinct.
So there's no D or R? It's
no,
just the name?
It's just the name.
No Dem?
No, it's just the name.
What about when you're voting for, like, the judges? And no, the judges, if you're keeping them or losing them, yes.
No, I'm talking about, like, the Senate and all that stuff. The mayor, all that.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
All right. So we're going to, we'll jump into some resolutions that actually been passed, because in addition to obviously voting people in office, there were some passed laws. So we're going to start with police reforms. There's a lot of them. NBC News, voters in at least six states overwhelmingly approved police reform measures on Election Day, reflecting a growing demand for greater law enforcement and accountability. Creating and strengthening police oversight boards, changing department staffing and funding levels, and allowing greater public access to body and dashboard cameras recordings were among the measures approved by voters across the country. Voters in nearly a dozen cities and counties, in California, Texas, Oregon, and Ohio approved the creating, overhauling, or strengthening police oversight boards. In Portland, Oregon, police protests have been going on since Floyd's death. Over 80% of the voters passed the measure, which amends the city's charter to create police oversight committee that would have the power to investigate use of deadly force and allegations of misconduct by the officers. Committee would also have the power to discipline officers for wrongdoing. So that's pretty awesome. That happened a lot. Seattle had some stuff going on. San Francisco, Oakland, Sonoma County, Akron, Ohio, Los Angeles County. So, and what's cool about what Los Angeles County did, in addition to a lot of these different rules and I guess laws and getting that oversight and getting that transparency, Los Angeles County voters approved a measure that would require the county to spend at least 10% of its annual general fund budget, or an estimated $360 million on alternatives to incarceration, such as job training, substance abuse programs, and mental health treatment.
That fixes problems, bro.
It does fix problems, and that's exactly what we'll get into it, you know, at the end. But, you know, with the drug laws that were passed, that's the whole point. It's like, instead of treating it as a problem with, you know, force and stuff like that, let's treat it as a social problem. 100%.
Yep.
So I guess it's long overdue. I'm glad they finally did it. So Nevada voters overturned an 18-year-old ban on same-sex marriage, making it the first state to enshrine gay couples' rights to marry in its constitution. So that's happening in Nevada. So
it was federal anyways, though, but
it was federal, but the reason they're doing this, David said members of the LGBTQ community wanted something concrete to protect same-sex marriage in case the federal level ever revokes it, which is what a lot of folks are worried about with the new Supreme Court. Amy Coney Barrett got elected. She's super conservative. They have a 6-3. So a lot of people were just really afraid that they're going to overturn that shit, which is why they did this, sadly enough. So you had something too, Laz, right? Transgender or something?
Oh, the first... sorry, I apologize.
It's all right. I can edit it.
Here we go. Delaware elects first openly transgender state senator.
Oh, yeah.
Democrat Sarah McBride won state Senate race on Tuesday in Delaware and would be the first openly transgender state senator in the country when sworn in. McBride defeated Republican Steve Washington to... This is from WSVN. That's Fox. Openly following the retirement of the longest-serving legislator in Delaware history.
Nice.
She won in a heavily Democratic district. Well, she's a Democrat, of course, so...
Of course.
That's how it happened.
Yeah. imagine transgender Republican. Holy crap. Yeah. Running for office. I'm sure they're out there, but...
McBride said to us tonight... It's my hope that a young LGBTQ kid here in Delaware or really anywhere in this country can look at the results and know that our democracy is big enough for them too.
Sure. Awesome.
It's different, but I mean, this is how we need to progress as humans. We need to do whatever it is to make everybody feel comfortable about whatever's going on. You know what I mean?
Yeah, 100%. Yeah. I mean, that's what we're supposed to be doing here in America. We're struggling with it as we have our entire freaking, you know, existence. But, you know, we're still trying to make it better. That's for sure. So, all right. So, Mondaire Jones, you guys heard this? George joins Richie Torres as first gay black man elected to Congress. Democrat Mondaire Jones won his House race in New York's 17th congressional district, defeating Republican Maureen McArdle Schulman by 54% to 40% with 72% of the votes in. So he ended up going on to win. Jones, 33, succeeds outgoing House Appropriations Committee Chair Nita Lowry, who didn't seek re-election. Jones and fellow Democrat Richie Torres, who won his race to represent New York's 15th congressional district, will be the first openly LGBTQ black members of Congress. A lot of that going on, which is awesome, and definitely, you know, a step in the right direction. So that being the case, I want to go into the drug laws because there's some shit here that I never thought I would see.
Not in our lifetime.
I mean, at all. Like the weed stuff going on, but I mean, we're just gonna jump in here. The Guardian: U.S. drug laws set for sweeping overhaul as voters choose decriminalization. Last night, Arizona, Montana, New Jersey, and South Dakota voted to decriminalize recreational marijuana. Really pissed off. I didn't think about it, and I should have to buy freaking weed stock because Tilray went like tripled in the last like four fucking days, like a dickhead. I didn't think about it. Meanwhile, and all of them, even the one you have, Lucas, did well. Meanwhile, Mississippi and South Dakota, medical marijuana will be legalized, taking the tally of U.S. states that have legalized the substance up to 15. And in Washington, D.C., psychedelic plants were decriminalized. So Washington, D.C., you can take some magic mushrooms. In Oregon, all illegal drugs.
That's fucking crazy.
Dude, all illegal drugs, including heroin, cocaine, and crystal meth, will be decriminalized. Meanwhile, psychoactive mushrooms will be legalized for therapeutic use. So it's like, all that shit, you can illegalize, but the mushrooms, just for therapeutic use, people. I don't know if I read that wrong.
The mushrooms are some other shit, though.
The drug dealer stopping in Oregon just went up.
Big time. Big time. But what's interesting is when it gets legalized, it just makes it more widely available and prices go down and all that shit.
But it's still illegal. It's just decriminal. It's still like...
You can't sell it.
Yeah, but you can have it.
I don't know how much it is. I think it's like less than like, or it's like a gram or something like that, which it's not an insignificant amount, to be honest with you.
For things like, you know, people that just want to do a bump here and there or not have a problem.
Yeah, for sure.
And then, but no, it ruins some of that shit could ruin your fucking life. Like,
if you have that type of personality where you can't step away from it or maybe you can,
but you just, you know, one day you probably do whatever you do and it's like once in a while you do it sometimes.
Sure.
Now, should you go to prison or jail because you have a that doesn't make any sense.
So there are other countries that have done it, mimicking successful pilots in Europe. In Europe, the initiative in Oregon places an emphasis on treating addiction as a health issue rather than one of law and order. Instead of jail times, those found in possession will have the option to either pay a $100 fine or sign up for addiction services. Proponents of the measure are hopeful the change will reduce overdose deaths, reduce racial disparities in drug sentencing and arrests, and drastically improve services of drug users across the country. The Drug Policy Alliance, which drafted and funded the measure in Oregon, says that $100 million could be saved each year in law enforcement savings from reduced arrests and incarceration and increased drug revenue from drug sales. Increased revenue from drug sales, I don't get that. I don't think they're selling cocaine or whatever. Maybe they're talking about the weed. I don't really get where that comes.
I don't know how that's gonna. I'm pretty sure they're not gonna be selling. They're not gonna legalize. Completely legalize.
Claim it on the tax forms.
The drug dealers will. That's pretty funny.
That'd be hilarious. So what do you do? I sell coke.
Yeah, man. Like,
hold on.
Let me pay my taxes.
Yeah, for sure. So, and the last one I got on this is 5 states okay measures eradicating racist language and symbols. Alabama voters. There's a big storm going out, by the way. Like, it's hurricane. What is it? Ida. Yeah, it's literally right down there in the fucking Keys. So it's kind of loud out there. So appreciate you guys for coming through. So maybe I guess
I was worried. Hey, look, when I asked you about flooding, coming down, you know, the main road that we come up to go this way.
Yeah.
It was flooding on that side. I'm like, yo, it better not be flooding over there. I'm turning the fuck around. No, like,
luckily where we live, they take care of the shit here. But yeah, like when you go over the bridge there, there's that one shopping center.
Remember the one I told you that not supposed to be dark?
Yeah. No, that whole area is out of power already.
Wow.
Yeah.
I'm just hoping we don't run out of power.
No, I think your power is underground.
Yeah. All right.
You'll be all right.
So 5 states okay measures eradicating racist language symbols. Alabama voters reversed themselves from a few years ago and removed racist vestiges of segregation from the state constitution that courts long ago ruled unconstitutional. Rhode Island did a similar U-turn to eradicate the words plantations from the state's official name. In addition, Alabama and Rhode Island residents of Utah and Nebraska decided to strip their constitution of unenforceable provisions that allowed slavery as a punishment for criminal convictions. So this shit was still in the fucking constitution. Can you believe it?
So that means if you did something that you weren't supposed to do, they could be like, look, it's in the constitution. It still happens in the...
Yeah, you know, you see stuff like, you know, oral sex is illegal in this state and blah, blah, blah. Just one of those fucking things. And then Mississippi, they adopted a magnolia instead of the Confederate flag, like in their flag. So thank the fucking Lord. So a little progress there. Happy about that.
We're progressing. I mean,
no, we are. Every election. Especially now the fucking Trump. Dude, when you, me, and Camilo, and Lucas, like when we were finished recording, you know, and then you guys left, like I was in going to bed. I was depressed. I thought Trump won. I was really disappointed and like straight up. I was like, really, America? Like they fucking got the Senate and the fucking president. I was like, I can't. This isn't like, I just couldn't fucking believe it. But now finally.
I still can't believe Florida went for Trump.
I can't. Well, Miami.
That's another story.
That is another fucking story.
No, but our city.
No, Miami Dade and Broward voted for Biden, but the rest of the state.
The memes. This is what I want to talk about. The memes are fucking hilarious.
Yeah,
bro.
But I'm pretty sure Trump won Miami Dade. Lucas, can you please look that up?
No, he didn't win.
Biden won.
Thank you for saying please.
Miami Dade.
Miami Dade, Broward,
Palm Beach.
He did end up winning those.
Okay. Yeah, and a lot of like. Random cities, so then they're
like Tampa,
saying,
Jacksonville.
People are saying we're not going to those other cities
fucking
or counties.
Florida, man, fucking it up.
But you're never gonna get like Florida's a Republican state. And it is what it is.
I don't know why.
Because we live here, so you don't understand, bro. Like
who's talking about he wants to send everybody back where they come from, build a wall.
Yeah, but all the old people move down here, and they're all you know.
And with old people that like want to live in the like. Crazy little small towns, and there's a lot. There's a places you can't go. There's places you can't go north of here, bro. Like it's not. I'm not talking about you, Lucas, in Philly. It's different. It's different in Florida. Like we have that old South mentality. Like once you get out of the real, we're the southernmost area in the United States.
And
but once you pass,
Broward is like its own country itself.
Yeah. So once you are a part of, like, it's not part of the state. Once you leave there, it's a wrap. Anything can happen to you over there.
You guys heard that Kanye got 60,000 votes, right?
No, they wrote
60,000 people voted for Kanye fucking West.
How many? 16 or 60?
60,000.
But they wrote his name down.
They wrote it down.
They have to write it. It's not going to be on the ballot.
But still. Like, come on, people. Talk about the slow version. So, all right. So I have an interesting rant. So, a friend of mine that I'm on Facebook friends with, he worked with us at the Fontainebleau. Kevin MC. I'm just going to keep it like that. He had an interesting rant. It's pro-Trump, but I'm going to go through it because some interesting points here. To those of you who voted for Biden, you'd better own it for the next 4 years if he wins. Parentheses, yeah. Lord help us. I don't want to hear you complain about your taxes going up or prices doubling, even tripling. By the way, gas has been under 230 for the past 4 years. Reason been under 230 is because we found out that we're the fucking Saudi Arabia of natural gas, and we've been fracking like fucking crazy. So that's for sure. But as far as taxes going up, I make less than $400,000 a year. Not that worried about it. And yes,
I'm not worried about
Trump
it.
Did lower taxes for everyone, but they found out at the end of the year, they ended up owing most of that fucking money back.
Back, yes.
They're not talking about that shit. Yes, you're paying less taxes, but you have to pay it all back at the end of the fucking year.
We don't pay less taxes, though.
Here, you don't have to worry. There's no state tax in Florida. Yeah, so for you guys, it didn't really much of an effect. I don't want to hear you complain about your tax going up. I already said that. Don't bother explaining yourself to me when your health insurance costs go up even further than they already are. Half of you don't even know about how your insurance works. Don't complain when you bring home less on your paycheck because you're going to be penalized for climate justice. So,
oh, God.
We're coming and we're climate justice and we're coming after you, sirs.
Get the fuck out of here.
Climate justice.
That's never going to happen.
I mean, come on, man. Renewable fucking energies, enough fucking oil, enough fucking gas, enough fucking coal. Like, come on. Can we move on, people? Climate fucking justice. Don't complain when you lose your job because 15 million illegal immigrants suddenly become legal and your employer decides to hire someone at a lower wage. Yep, I said it. They will take your job after going to university and paying $80 a year. That is borrowed. Or so. $80,000. It said 80, but I'm sure he meant 80K. That is borrowed. Oh. Whatever. That's a fucking American dream. Look at Elon Musk. He wasn't fucking born here. Bitch is going to Mars in fucking 10 years.
Yep.
Doesn't fucking matter.
The fuck, man. Albert Einstein, he wasn't fucking born here. Jim Carrey, he wasn't born here.
No immigrant is taking your fucking job, if that's how you feel about it or whatever.
Look, if he's taking your fucking job, it's because you're probably a janitor or some shit like that.
Look at Arnold, he wasn't born here. He's governor of California.
Yeah, exactly. That means it's the fucking American dream, people.
Everybody comes from fucking the country.
We all came from somewhere.
Yeah, no shit.
We all came from somewhere else.
I don't know, Ricky. I feel like your ancestors were born here for sure, bro.
No, hour and a half from here.
It's fucking impossible. Unless
no
one's
fucking born. Nope.
Unless you're Native American, fucking shut it.
Second, third generation. No way.
What, Lucas?
I found the information about Miami Beach at least.
Well, Miami Beach is Miami-Dade County.
Yeah.
Yeah. But it's all good. They already said it was Biden.
Yeah, 19 out of 24 precincts report more than 50% of the votes went to Biden.
Okay, fair enough. I guess I was wrong.
Yeah, it's the rest of Florida that didn't get it together.
All right, so don't complain when your automotive or industrial job is eliminated because it's shipped back to China. This is a good one. One of the things that I loved about Trump, we talked about it, love his foreign policy. I hope that Biden keeps that shit going. We got to stop getting all of our shit from over there incrementally, whatever we got to fucking do.
I agree with that.
So I agree with this, and you know, I hope that Biden keeps that shit going. Don't complain when interest rates double or even triple and home automobiles are not as affordable as they used to be. Don't see that happening.
My brother's bike just came. And I was telling them Ricky had bought a four-wheeler. It took forever to come. And my brother's bike just got ready like last week. And it's been like 6 months.
Finally.
But not 6 months. We bought it in June.
June?
Because, my son's bike came the same day. So
it's like 4 months, 5 months?
Yeah. Sure, 5 months.
But that's the whole, like, if we were able to buy things that were here, that wouldn't happen.
Sure.
Made in America. And I agree with that. That's the only thing I agree with.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah.
Like, for sure. I mean, like I said, medication, a lot of our medication's made over there. People can get that shit. So don't complain when interest rates double or triple. I already said that. Don't complain when your stocks and 401k take a massive hit. We don't know. I'm curious to see what the markets do tomorrow when they open up. Don't complain when we are locked in.
That happened when it was in fucking Bush, bro. All that shit he's talking about right now, when we had 8 years of Bush, that shit happened.
Well, here's the thing. We got 130 freaking thousand coronavirus cases in a day, and then we got an elected president finally in. So I'm really curious to see what happens. Well, we're going to have Mark and Matt come in and talk to us about it, too.
Yeah, because we had that one president that wasn't telling people to wear masks. Oh,
yeah.
Well, the thing is, too, that's going to come back up in the news. Like, after next week, we're going to start getting shut down again.
Well, yeah, especially because all these people are going to the streets and partying. And, you know, I get it. Like, let's party for sure. Woohoo. But a lot of them didn't have masks on. Oh. All right. Don't complain when the educational system goes down and your higher education becomes unaffordable. You obviously didn't vote your paycheck into your future. You voted your feelings. Unfortunately, facts don't care about your feelings and will soon learn that under a Biden-Harris administration, you will learn that. Just own it. Be proud of the voice you have. Also, when the new administration makes a play for all of our legally owned weapons, don't look to me for support, safety, or compliance. I'll be fighting to the death to defend my God-given Second Amendment rights.
He sounds very
end
upset.
Of rant. Shoo.
That's never going to happen. They can't take the guns.
Nah, it's never going to fucking happen. Kamala Harris, first woman elected, black woman elected, father was freaking Jamaica, mother's from India, so India.
That's fucking great.
Dude, that's great because India, like I said, they, like, you know, brothers and sisters in India that listen to us every freaking week, like in droves. So our vice president, you know, mom was from your city, so, or from your country, which is freaking awesome. So she's breaking down all kinds of barriers. Joe Biden, 77 years old, 74 million votes cast for him. And one of the quotes from his acceptance speech that he had, what was it, last night? We will lead not only by our example of our power, but by the power of our example. So little fireworks and drones and all that shit. So did you guys see it? Did you guys watch that at all?
No.
I wanted to, but...
Oh, God. I wanted to. I watched it. It was cool. It wasn't that long, like 45 minutes. Kamala Harris came out first, then Joe Biden. But they had, like, fireworks and, like, the drones, like, up there writing and Biden Harris. And
oh, really?
Yeah, it was cool, man. It was really cool.
I'm just happy that it's all over.
I'm happy it's over, too.
Yeah, fuck, bro.
Trump's going to keep fighting, but, you know, it's fucking over.
They're going to have to drag him out.
What, Lucas?
Doesn't matter what side you're on, we're all happy that the mail is going to stop.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
So actually, my aunt got something today. She's like, are you fucking kidding me? Like, I never.
No, they kept doing it after. After even.
They just didn't get here yet. There's so much of those, they couldn't get them processed fast enough.
Oh, I want to see when the last thing we get, like the last text message or last piece of mail.
Right.
Let's see how long it's going to. Because I still got something on Friday, I think.
Did you really?
Mail-wise.
Oh, there's no mail?
No, like mail from, can I call them solicitors?
You can say that, I guess. Yeah, campaigners.
Campaigners.
Yeah, I was getting one every, oh man, that was annoying.
Yeah, exactly. I'm pretty sure the last one I got was on Friday.
And no, but I remember I told you, I'm on Trump's email list, so I get emails.
Oh, yeah.
Yes. We'll continue to fight.
They text him. They called you to text you.
They text me.
It's like, we're going to continue to fight for Trump. Don't worry.
All right, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi congratulated Biden for his spectacular victory and called on the success of Harris, whose mother was born in India, a path-breaking achievement. Modi tweeted that Vice President under Barack Obama, Biden's contribution to strengthening Indo-U.S. relations was critical and valuable, so they love Biden. I look forward to working closely together once again to take India-U.S. relations to greater heights. India loves us, too, because we're not the closest with China. They're having issues with China, so, you know, we've always been close, but we're actually getting a lot closer. And then Jamaica, Prime Minister Andrew Holness said Harris becoming vice president-elect was a monumental achievement. What are you laughing at, Lucas? Holness?
Nah, Jamaica? I hardly know her.
Oh, God.
So it's one of those, the enemy of my enemy is my friend?
Sure.
And the fact that they're from, I mean, they're, Kamala Harris has heritage from both countries.
So, absolutely.
So that's.
All right. So that's what's up, man. That's pretty much all we got. Go ahead, Lucas. What?
Now, did you guys see that Paris lit off fireworks and all that? Like other countries are celebrating?
Oh, when we won?
Yeah.
No, I didn't. Oh, when we won. I didn't know that. No. Yeah.
I didn't know you were right, cool. Too.
Like, they rang bells in Paris and fireworks in London.
So that means Trump rubs a lot of people the wrong way.
No,
yeah, it's not a fucking secret.
When your own political party is happy that you're not in the White House.
And when Russia is like wanting you to be the president, you know, and when a lot of these other countries that we're not necessarily closest with, Brazil, Brazil, who fucking guy caught himself, was super, super anti getting masks and stuff like that. And you know, he wants Trump to win. Like, you got to look at the people who are voting for this guy countries wide.
They tell you, like, Republicans are saying, finally, the country's gonna go where it's the way it's supposed to go.
Yeah,
so, I mean, I gotta see who said it. I gotta find out who said it. I had it, but I can't.
There's a lot of Republicans that said
yeah, but
that
they that,
no, but I get that. But my thing is, why didn't you say it before?
Because you can't.
You can't, because if he wins, then all of a sudden you got it. The president who's pissed off at you. Now they can actually open their mouths and be truthful. So, all right, we're gonna take our next break, and then we're gonna come back with Lucas's weather. Anyone an asshole or anyone got beef, anything like that?
Ricky had beef, right?
Nah, my beef is another show itself.
It's all right. I'm sure we got a little bit of time. All right, we're going to take a break. We'll be back very shortly. Boom.
Boom. Boom.
I've been waiting for you to knock down my front door. 'Cause you can't take it anymore. I've been waiting. Share me with the
any better?
Fatigue,
yeah,
and booze, right. Don't mix.
Speaking of which, I have those wires coming in the mail.
Oh, perfect for the compressor. Yeah, I got Lucas a compressor. Freaking A. So we'll have a compressor on his audio going in, so I won't have to compress it as much on this side, which will be much better for editing, that's for sure. So
And there's no way you could turn up Laz or Ricky on for my end, because I could barely hear both of them.
Not really.
You can't turn up your headset?
Well, we can't hear Laz at all, like, right now.
Why not?
I don't know.
Like, I'm not, I wasn't
coming. There you go. So like you gotta be close to the mic, that's all.
Like, I could hear you perfect, Seth.
You can sit back and just, that's because I have good mic technique.
That's bullshit.
Yeah. Here we go.
This motherfucker. I remember in the beginning when I was fucking nervous as fuck.
Oh, really? What, yeah. Like what, the first show?
No, like the first, the beginning, the first, like,
yeah. For sure.
Like, now
look at you.
Like, well, because you always thinking about the mic. Now it's like, I don't
even remember the first show.
I can't, that's why I was saying, I can't remember the studio.
The first show ever was Colin Kaepernick. So, all right, so we're back and we're going to jump into Lucas's Weber. I'm just going to say Weber on purpose now. So I think I should just go ahead and just own it at this point. So, Lucas, are you ready with your weather?
Yes, I'm ready with my Weber.
Okay, your Weber. All right. So, Lucas, hold on.
Research Lucas with the weather.
Where do we
weather,
have her weather, this week?
This week, I'm bringing it back to the home, to our home of United States, the state of Virginia.
Okay, Virginia. Okay.
Yep. The town of Goochland.
Goochland? So, I mean, let me ask you guys this. First of all, does any one of us not know what a gooch is?
I don't know what gooch is.
You do not know what a gooch is.
I've heard gooch, but I don't know. Oh, the gooch from different stalks.
No. Okay. All right.
Okay.
So, Lucas, would you like to fill him in on what the gooch is? You hear this a lot on Jackass as well, as a matter of fact. They reference the gooch.
What I understand is there's actually a difference between a gooch and a taint.
There is a difference?
That's
I
what
thought
I
they
heard.
Were both the same.
It's the same, but the only difference is gooch is man, taint is female.
Oh.
So like what exactly is the gooch?
They're still the same flap skin. Or
okay.
Lack thereof.
So, okay.
A gooch or a taint is the space between the genitalia and the butthole.
Pretty much. You didn't know that, Laz? No.
That shit feels good, though.
What?
God.
Okay.
I can't explain.
We're keeping it real here. Laz is corn
Girls
positivity.
Are so fucking dirty.
No, but okay. I thought you said the gooch was from the bully from District Strokes. That's what I oh, the gooch.
No, the gooch. Damn, that's what it's called.
Okay, all right. Well, then, gooch land in Virginia. Anything. Goodness yeah, gracious. I, is it? How can you spell that for the listeners at home, please?
G-O-O-C-H-L-A-N-D.
Goochland.
Goochland.
And I could not find any information.
Lick my Goochland, well, bitch.
Any interesting information except for Goochland is featured in season 7, episode 15 of The X-Files.
Okay. All right.
In which of a child, the child of a local Christian family is miraculously cured of cancer.
Okay.
See?
Goochland, Virginia.
Yep.
All right. Voted for Trump, Virginia. It's okay.
It's fine.
We should see what a Goochland County
did. Yeah, we did too. What's that?
There is also Goochland County.
Okay. Okay, so let's start with Tuesday.
Tuesday, November 10th. High 75, low 63. Partly cloudy with a chance of precipitation at 20% and the winds coming out of the south at 5 miles per hour.
Okay.
Wednesday, November 11th. High 73, low 66. Rain. With the chance of precipitation at 80%, with the winds coming out of the south at 8 miles per hour.
Okay.
Thursday, November 12th, high of 69. Nice. Low of 52.
Okay. He's cracking himself up over there, yep. Folks.
We'll have rain at 100% chance with the winds coming out of the northwest at 6 miles per hour.
Okay.
Friday, November 13th, high 64, low 42. Ooh. AM showers with the chance of precipitation at 40% with the winds coming out of the north at 5 miles per hour.
Okay.
Finish off at Saturday, November 14th, high 60, low 45. Partly cloudy with a chance of precipitation at 20% with the winds coming out of the northeast at 5 miles per hour.
All right.
And that is the weather for Goochland.
The weather for Goochland.
So it's going to look a little moist most of the week.
Okay. All right. So, Research Lucas. With the weather. Goochland, Virginia. Who'd have thunk? All right. Well, I guess with that, so just want to make sure nobody thinks they're an asshole, right?
I might be.
Oh, okay.
What? You got beef?
We'll save that for later. And for now, we're going to know if Lucas wants to know, that is.
Am I an asshole?
Take it away.
Am I an asshole?
So I was talking to this girl, you know, a couple weeks and all that. What? What's so funny? Name?
Now continue.
Lucas talking to a girl, please.
Yeah.
Hold on, let me set the scene.
You know, and after a while, you know, getting to know each other, sends me, huh?
No, nothing.
It's like a cow.
It's a frog.
Yeah.
You know, nighttime froggy misty dew. Please, Lucas, go ahead.
And after a while, she sends me some pictures. You know, ones. You know, a couple of them with her boobs out.
Mm-hmm.
And all I said was neat, and she hasn't texted me back yet.
You texted her neat?
Am I an asshole for that, or did I do something wrong?
That's all you said, neat?
Yeah, I said neat.
Neat.
Like, is that offensive or something?
That's not a compliment.
It doesn't sound very like you're interested.
Yeah, like neat.
Neat. Cool, I guess.
Oh. How about douche? Is that one of the... Can I take a douche for 200, Alex? Oh.
Guess you're not getting any pictures anymore.
Way to bring it down, Seth.
I know, right?
That's my job.
So, yeah, I wouldn't say you're an asshole. You're just an idiot. Neat. Well, those are very nifty, miss.
I'd like to see those in person.
Those are swell.
Actually, they could probably swell a little more, if I'm being completely honest. But those are pretty swell.
You should have sent her a picture.
My name's Lucas.
She's basically alley-ooped you a nude, and you said neat.
Neat. The only thing that should be neat is a fucking cocktail. A liqueur.
True.
Okay, well.
Jesus Christ. You just fucked up.
Dude. All right, so anyone else think they're an asshole?
We're all assholes.
All right, so Ricky, you said you had some beef.
Yes, I do.
Okay, Ricky has some beef.
What?
Please.
You got beef?
Take it away, Ricky.
The first beef was coming from the lovely dealership called Infinity. So...
Dealership Infinity. Okay. Yeah.
The one right there in North Miami. So I had a 2017 Infiniti Q50. Mind you, I bought it, fixed it, whatever. It was rebuilt. So a couple of weeks back, it started cutting off on me for no reason. So I started freaking out. The car's fairly new. It shouldn't be giving me this problem. So I get it towed to Infiniti. And they gave me it's $350 for the estimate. It's going to go towards your repair cost. Shouldn't be nothing much, this and that. I told them the problem. I will diagnose it. So the next day, the rep calls me, said, I invoiced you the estimate and what's wrong with the problem. These motherfuckers troubleshoot me. The computer's bad. All right, fine. Did the research on the computer. It's supposed to be 1600. Then you have to change the harness. Then the twin turbos are going bad. You have to change that coolant system, this and that.
Jesus Christ.
Guess how much this shit costs?
Well... For $4,500. Hold on, wait. Let's go around. Lucas.
I know how much it costs.
He knows the price, but if you didn't know
Lucas
the price...
Lucas is the car guy. Give him the list.
Yeah, what was... Speaking to the mic, because I got to hear this.
Computer, turbo...
Twin turbos, the computer, the harness, labor, everything.
What? What's your make and model?
2017 Q50 3.0.
It's Infinity.
2017. Okay.
You're probably looking 6 or 7 range.
Six or seven range? Okay.
Yeah, that's labor parts. Because the computer is expensive, twin turbo and all that.
Okay.
And the answer is?
$18,860. When I looked at the shit, I'm like, fuck you. I'm sorry.
I thought he was fucking around, bro. And I'm like, yo, you have to be fucking kidding me.
Well, hold on.
Wow, $18,000.
It's a 2017 what?
Q50.
What the fuck is like?
No, so the labor was like 14 hours.
What are you going to do then?
I sold the car.
Okay.
No, he told the people he sold the car that had the problem.
Here's the worst part. So when I told the guy, oh, that's too much for me. Well, I can put you on the payment plan. Good luck. And then what topped it off of that, a couple of days later, they email me, rate your experience at Infinity. Fuck
that. You didn't tell me that.
I showed it to you.
Fuck.
Wow. That's pretty fucking hilarious. All right. So, Laz, Lucas, any beef out there?
No, with the Mr. No. Fix.
What? You got beef?
No, I'm good.
Okay. All right. So, I got some pre-beef that, you know, obviously we got to take care of. So... Mr. Ricky.
What?
Bro, what the fuck, beef? Bro? How you gonna cancel on us 2 weeks in a row?
Oh, mind you, he didn't tell you I got into a wreck that day before I was supposed to come here.
So that wreck, did you tell me about that wreck, Laz?
When I spun out on the highway?
No, I didn't tell you because I feel like that's something he should tell you.
Okay.
Oh, God.
Well, I'm not gonna, I don't give everybody
okay,
his impression.
Okay, so let's rephrase this, bro. Hold on.
What? You got beef?
So why the fuck you gotta cancel like right before he's gonna fucking pick you up instead of saying, yo, bro, I was just in a wreck.
That's the fucking problem.
So how about that?
But you know I was pissed off.
It doesn't matter though.
I could have got killed on the highway.
I saw you the same day and you're like, I'm going. Like for example, like today, and I'm like, all right, Rick, you ready to go? And then you would have just like, no, I'm not going anywhere. Fuck it. That's exactly what you did.
Yes, because I spun out on the highway, hit 12 poles, faced the obstacle. You know what? Fuck.
Okay, that's fair. So, you know, just don't fucking cancel like right when you're on the fucking way. The whole reason you're here is because Ility had to cancel, and she was gracious enough to do it at 11 o'clock in the morning so we could fucking get your ass here.
All right, you know what? I apologize, number one. Number two, if I get shot, I'll make sure to hobble here. I'll hobble my ass here and still come, okay?
Yes, you should.
Fair?
It'll be just good camera footage.
No, you don't have to hobble here. Just fucking cancel right after you get shot. That's all. It's like, yo, bro, I just got shot. I don't think I'm going to be able to make it today. You know, so, I mean, can you give me a next week or some shit like that? So, all right.
Nah, I get it.
All right, cool. Good deal. Well, it all worked out, didn't it? All right. Well, we don't have any updates because I knew we weren't going to have time for them. So I guess review us, follow us, like us, subscribe, all that neat shit. Any last minute thoughts? How about last? Any corner positivity last?
Weren't we supposed to talk about something else?
I don't think so.
No, about the sports. It sucks.
Oh, sports? Okay. Yeah. I mean, it wasn't on the docket, but sure. Sports sucked. We were supposed to talk sports, but of course, you know, you couldn't make it.
Somebody didn't show up.
So, you know. I mean, I thought the NBA was cool. I kind of liked it. You know, it wasn't as cool. If they weren't pumping in the sounds from the crowd, it would suck. But the fact they're doing it still gives you the ambiance of a real game, in my opinion, on TV.
I didn't like it. It looks so artificial. Side note, they're starting back up on the 23rd.
What?
December? NBA.
Yeah.
I don't think it's going to happen that way. Unless they officially
they're doing 72
it.
Games. It's been confirmed.
Oh, but it's going to be empty stadiums. Yeah.
I know the NBA stood to gain like $1 billion if they opened up a month earlier. So I guess they found a way to get that to the players or something like that. Because nobody, dude, they just finished. You know, you think LeBron James wants to fucking start training camp? That means training camp starts like in a week or two. So they don't want to deal with that shit.
Yeah, he's missed the competition, right? He should handle it.
I suppose. But you know what, man? Sometimes the old men got to rest their knees, bro. I know all about it. That's for sure. NFL has been great. What's that, Luke? What's Lucas? What's that last?
I have a positivity.
Oh, you do?
I was going to use it last week.
Positivity.
Okay. What happened last week? I don't remember. I don't remember anything from last week.
No, don't judge me. Dude.
I got to watch.
If anyone didn't see last week's, Laz is fucking in a great fucking place. That's all I can say.
I can imagine.
You got to watch, dude. It's just like, whatever, dude. I'll tell you what, man. 12, 13 shows. We're back doing this. 11, 12 shows. Like, you know, every once in a while, just got to have a good time.
Yeah.
So, Chick-fil-A. I've never been to Chick-fil-A. I don't know.
You've never been to any Chick-fil-A?
Never.
You're lying.
What?
They're not close to my house. I never see them.
There's one right there on the tour that just opened up.
They just opened it, but they're not around me at all. And I'm never driving.
So all the road trips we took and everything,
I've never even seen one.
Bro.
All I do is hear about it.
Chick-fil-A, dude.
So.
It'll change your life.
It's fucking delicious.
Mr. Lee barely got his car into Chick-fil-A parking lot in Maryland. He was a regular there, but this time the 96-year-old World War II veteran strolled up to the counter. He was shaking and almost in tears. He told the clerk that he had a flat tire and didn't know what to do. The clerk quickly alerted the manager, Daryl Hardward, and he walked Mr. Lee back out to his car. Then Daryl took care of things, jacking up the car, put the spare tire on his car, and all that time took about 15 minutes. Another store manager at the time, Rudy Somoza, took pictures of Daryl changing the tire and posted it to social media.
Nice.
His actions, says Rudy, his actions of kindness was beautiful. Daryl has always been so helpful to anyone in need and deserves recognition, and we think so, too. That's what I said.
Very, very nice.
I follow this thing on Facebook. I'm going to have a lot of positive things.
Oh, good.
But I'm not going to tell you where I'm getting it from.
I don't care where you get it from.
I'll be honest with you. If they ever have a bad review, I'll be shocked.
Yeah, I never hear anything bad about them at all.
You're never going to hear it.
They got a lot of shit for their, I think it's LGBTQ or maybe.
Yeah, I heard about that.
Well, they're very Christian
company. But I'm talking about customer service.
Oh, dude, they're fucking great. They just so happy to serve you and smiles.
I just wish they were open on Sundays.
It's like In-N-Out Burger is the same thing.
You know, I want to try that. I heard it's so good.
Because the fries are fresh. They cut them right fucking there. You know?
Like from the potato, this little thin burger.
What's that?
Like they make fries out of like the actual potato in the
place. It's a burger place. I mean, you can get doubles and like, you know, animal style.
I heard if you never had that in your life, you're missing out.
Yeah, for sure.
Okay.
But they're not here. That's exactly it. They're up north. West Coast only.
What, Five Guys?
No.
No, I heard it's way better.
Yeah.
Five Guys. That's not only West Coast. You can get that here. Five Guys is good too, but.
But no, I did, with Chick-fil-A, I did see somebody make a fake advertisement saying that their pickles don't touch just like God intended for their sandwiches. Don't touch.
Okay. So even displacement or even placement of the pickles is equal balance pickle arrangement.
Like, I mean, that pickle makes a difference in that sandwich though.
Sure. Nothing beats just the plain old McDonald's, like the plain old McDonald's cheeseburger, dude. It's just like
they still do those like 59-cent burgers on like Sundays.
I haven't seen that in a while.
I haven't been to fast food. The only thing I'll do fast food is I'll hit up a Taco Bell on the way in. Every once in a while on the way in, I'll pull roll up in there.
Yeah, so you can never get rid of Taco. That's the only thing I think since I've been younger like that hasn't like changed. That? Taco Bell is fucking great, bro.
Dude, I just can't eat it that much. I
especially
can't.
On a night when you're like, and then you're like, Taco Bell, please.
You're like, Taco Bell.
Yeah.
For sure. So, all right. Well, I guess that's pretty much it. So, Ricky, thank you for filling in. It's the only way you're going to get your ass back. I know, right? Again, dude. Literally fucking like 3 minutes from the end of the fucking show and my voice cracks. I went the whole fucking show.
Dude, I was trying to hold back because he cracked so bad a few times on the show. I just could not hold back anymore.
It's just the big ones. So anyway, yeah, I'm glad you got on. Like I said, it's probably the only way you're going to get on the show. Worked out perfectly. So it's
been a pleasure.
We'll have to get you a t-shirt and so you can, you know, share with your friends and all that stuff. And I guess that's it. Any last minute thoughts? Yeah. All right. We got Seth and Mike 1. We got Laz and Mike 2. We got Lucas and Mike 3.
Hey.
We got Shake and Bake Ricky, Dr. Talk in Mike 4. And that's pretty much it. We're out because we said so.
Because we said so.
Boom.